Welcome to another episode of the Dental Review Guide. This is Dr. Varun Acharya reviewing the most relevant products for dentistry. And, you know, during these difficult times, a lot of times you're going to hear about disinfection. We need to absolutely be on top of our game for disinfection. And one of the products you're going to very frequently hear is sodium hypochlorite. And you're going to hear it in different concentrations. Why? Because you're going to use 1% sodium hypochlorite for the floor, and you're going to use 0.5% sodium hypochlorite for, let's say, disinfecting a denture or a crown or a bridge. But here's where things get a little confusing. When you call up your chemical supplier, he's going to tell you, look, I have a 10% solution or I have a 5% solution or some other concentration. So that's what we're going to call the stock solution. So now with that stock solution, you need to dilute it appropriately to the correct concentration. And if you go back to your high school chemistry, that formula was V1C1 equals to V2C2. So V1 is the original volume of the stock solution which you're going to use. C1 is the concentration of the stock solution. So it may be 5%, it could be 10%, it could be 4%. And V2C2 is the final volume of the diluted solution you need, and C2 is the final concentration. So a couple of friends I spoke to were making a mistake on this. So for example, a person I know bought a 10% solution and they wanted to convert it to a 1% solution to mop the floors with in their clinic. So I asked him, how are they going to do it? And he said, well, it's very simple. It's a 1:10 dilution. So you're going to take 1 liter of the stock solution and 10 liters of water. Now this is a mistake. This is not actually 1%. This is an over diluted solution. What actually is the right answer here is to use 1 liter of the stock solution and 9 liters of water. So we have to remember that in that V2C2 part of the equation, V2 is the volume of the final solution. It is not the volume of water. So for example, if you look at sodium hypochlorite like this, the vendor may supply it to you and it says 5%, and now you want to get this as a 1% 10 liter diluted solution to mop the floors of your clinic, then you would take 2 liters of the stock solution and empty it into a bucket of 8 liters of water. And that changes. Now, let's say this solution which your supplier gave you was a 4% stock solution. You would need to do 2.5 liters of the stock solution and empty that into a bucket of 7.5 liters of water. This order is very important. You never add water to the stock solution, especially in hypochlorite. You would always have a bucket of water and you would add slowly the stock solution to that. The next important point I have to stress on is we're going to be mixing a lot of these chemicals. You must have labeling and you must do it properly. You do not want to use the wrong thing in the wrong place. And if it's accidentally used in the patient's mouth, you're expecting it to be something else. Or maybe you're expecting hand sanitizer and you're actually sanitizing your hands with hypochlorite, which is bleach. That's going to be a big problem. So label everything clearly and don't intermix the bottles once you've labeled them. Just keep that for that particular purpose alone. So with that, I'm going to share a couple of slides of some common concentrations, and you should hopefully find that useful when you're mixing up these chemicals in your clinic. This doesn't just apply to hypochlorite. You may be wanting to mix hydrogen peroxide or some other solution, but all of this is, you know, the laws of chemistry will apply to all of it. So these slides should hopefully be helpful to you. So till we meet again, this is the Dental Review Guy signing off with a smile.